no creativity as far as social media is here. All right, now I'm going to introduce our earnest and long-awaited round one participants. Are you ready? All right. You're welcome for that. That was a good show. Thank you all for staying down. All right, our very first artist is...
In Wichita Falls. Six, just 20 minutes on the clock to go from blank canvas, incredible masterpiece right in front of your eyes. You, the audience, will vote on which artists you think are the best. The top two artists, as voted by the audience, will move into third and final round, and will paint again. So lots of exciting stuff going on tonight. Pretty high stakes for these artists as well. Only the winner of this event in Wichita Falls. So we've been painting for less than a minute and got quite a lot of action going on already. I could see this artist curling. Always a great prep technique. Gonna get some nice lines there. Lots of prep work happening. And looks like this is Cheryl Hazelton at easel number 4. And she is squirting what looks like a burnt sienna card. The canvas, she has it braced across the easel, keeping it flat. So I have a gravity. She's keeping it flat to make sure the gravity doesn't have too much of an effect on it. So potentially we could see Cheryl painting very heavily if this is her strategy right off the to keep things level. And we can see Derek Holder is absolutely stunning gradient. This beautiful rainbow happening across the top. Some just really soft blends. Derek is really his ability to create these very peaceful and star at Art Battle Wichita Falls. So can't. Can see that Stephanie is working in monochrome at this really working on some careful technique, but we can see by looking at the palette there's quite a few different colors solely monochrome. Lots of and here we are with Natalia Hernandez. And I think we have a few cats at the easel in this round. And with this beautiful easel view that our camera person has for us right now, we can see that there are two being painted. I wonder if these artists have coordinated this or if this is totally unknown to each of them and will be a surprise when they step back at the end of the timer. Lots of great texture going on from Natalia. We can really see that there's a lot of ridge work in the fur of the cat, and that's purely just based on this application technique that she's got going on right now, which is very heavy and texture-based, and is makes for a great tactile painting experience. At easel 6, here we are with Harlan Watley. And Harlan Watley likes to style himself as the pop art cowboy. He really loves to paint kind of Western images, cowboys, Native American themes, and really brings a pop sensibility to it with lots of bright color work and an intentionally primitive style of drawing. Looks like we've got some green going on in the shawl right now of this cowboy. We've got quite a lot done here from Harlan in just under 7 minutes. And he's using a pretty small brush to place this color here. And I think that that is intentional because I think that he wants to get kind of this sketchy style of coloring going on. Here we are with Belinda Strayhorn at easel number 5. And Belinda looks like she is executing some sort of bird. At least that's the impression that I'm getting just from the line of what I think is the back of the bird and the neck potentially. I think that we're looking at kind of a ghostly swan in like a midnight pond landscape. But again, we have lots of time left on the clock to see how this piece is going to emerge. If you have any guesses, I would love to hear it in the comments. And we can see that Belinda is using a reduction technique where she's placed a lot of paint on the canvas and now has a rag and is wiping it away, reducing the amount of paint in those areas to reveal the white canvas underneath, but it has been toned slightly by that blue paint. And so it's creating this really kind of ghostly glowing air. And speaking of texture, from Cheryl here, we have lots and lots of texture going on. She is applying paint with a piece of paper and pulling it away to create all of this wonderful texture, almost like an earth kind of quality, like dirt intentionally. And Cheryl has this square of pure color in the middle of this piece that is surrounded by that masking tape. So there's going to be some clean lines there. And I'm not sure whether or not that tape was placed on before or after this yellow color. So I'm really looking forward to the tape reveal from Cheryl's canvas. I think that that's going to be really satisfying. We are halfway through the round. Officially, we have 10 minutes remaining on the clock. And check out the gorgeousness that is happening on Derek's easel here. Just such a soft application technique. Such beautiful, subtle gradients. I absolutely am adoring the crisp line of the mountains as they rise into that sunset sky. Just really beautiful. And the contrast of the purple clouds, I think, is such a mature way of painting this landscape. Often when we're seeing clouds, we're used to them being these little white fluffy elements. But Derek has actually painted them in this dark purple to show how light and shadow is affecting them at sunset. And I think that that is just such a stunning, subtle difference in this piece that I think is gonna make a really big impact. More work happening on this kitty cat from Stephanie. And she's got this kind of painterly wiped out background of gray, and then is using more contrast with the black and the white in the center of the canvas. The cat is taking up a smaller amount of space, so I'm wondering if she's going to use some of that background to kind of frame out the cat a little bit better, and kind of bring it more holistically into the rest of the canvas to kind of harmonize that composition, or if she's intentionally keeping the focus very, very central here. And moving over shortly to our other cat painter with our orange canvas here. And we can see that this artist has painted the sides of the canvas as well. I always love that. I think that that is such a professional touch to add to these paintings. It really helps to bring it into being a finished work. It is a live piece, and so live pieces often have elements of unfinishedness, but bringing the color over onto the sides of the canvas, I think just creates that that harmonizing element, that finishing piece that really just screams professionalism. And this is Natalia Hernandez at easel number one here. And the way that Natalia is painting this white cat here is almost reminding me of like a ceramic cat, like a kind of ceramic sculpture that you would maybe see in the 1950s. And very stylized, the way that she's going at it. Very cute with this kind of rosiness coming off of the nose, and the way that she's framed it out with that bold orange just really helps the subtleties that are happening in the gray areas of the fur to really sing. There's a simple color application here, but I think that she's done it really effectively. And back at easel number six with Harlan, our pop art cowboy. I think my favorite part about this piece so far is how small the top of the cowboy hat is. It's such a stylized element, and to me it brings a sense of whimsy and makes it a little bit cheeky that the proportions are off in this way, and I'm really enjoying that. And as far as the execution of the painting goes, I like this kind of three-quarter profile, and the way that Harlan is doing it is reminding me a little bit of some kind of cubist elements with these simplified shapes. Moving back over with Belinda here, and I think that we were correct in thinking that this was a bird, and now we can see that a heron has emerged from the darkness. Such a stunning way of capturing the moonlight on the feathers of this bird. Such a great use of that kind of reductionist technique where she scraped away the paint and it's left this glowing white, and then she's added even harsher highlights in with that pure white paint over top of that. and is just skimming that white highlight against the black leg of the bird. I think that there's a really careful use of contrast in this piece, and I am really, really enjoying it. And back with Cheryl at easel number 4. And we missed the tape reveal, but what a reveal it is. Now we can see the elements that are left behind. We can see that not only has she taken off the tape that we first saw at the very beginning that she put down to frame everything out, but now we can see that, yes, she did place masking tape down immediately after putting on that yellow kind of sienna color, and has just used it so thoughtfully and created this geometric shape that brings us into the center of the composition. Really just a phenomenal job here from Cheryl. And we've got our little honeybee in the middle there, very sweetly, with that little heart next to it. And I really have to commend Derek here, as we move over to his easel, the softness and the way that he's been able to execute this landscape is just so, so impressive. Often at Art Battle, we see a really heavy paint application, just differing styles, you know, but that's the more common element that we tend to see in Art Battle is a heavier painting style. So it is refreshing to see this really, really soft gradient work that is making a lot of use of the luminosity of the blank canvas underneath. Really just stunning work from Derek. And he's just very thoughtfully kind of wisping out these cacti that are in the distance of this desert that he's creating. And by diffusing them and just kind of buffing out their sharpness a little bit, he's really allowing them to be perceived as if they're coming from a distance. So that's a great perspective there. And Stephanie here, getting into our final seconds, I think that we are having a totally monochrome painting, and I think that she's done a fantastic job of creating with a lot of contrast here, and really enjoying the kind of cute little head tilt that's going on in our feline friend here. And that marks the conclusion of round number 1 in Art Battle Wichita Falls. Great first showing from these artists. Round number 2 are going to have their work cut out for them and going to have a lot of quality to battle against. Now is your time as audience to vote at artbattle.com/vote. You will choose one artist as your favorite. So when you are choosing, think not only about which painting is the best painting in your eyes? Which one is your favorite visually? But also think about the performance of these artists, and who would you like to see paint again? Because the top two artists, as voted by the audience, will be moving forward into a third and final round and will be painting once again. So this is, now is your time to choose who you want to see paint again. All of the works created here tonight are also available for silent auction at that same link. That link is on the screen right now, and you don't need to be in the room to purchase these works. We will ship them to you. Great opportunity to get into the collecting game early. We will be back for round number two in just a few minutes with another six artists at the easel, another six blank canvases, and another 20 minutes on the clock. Stay tuned. Have just selected our wild card artist. At Art Battle, we like to keep one or two easels open at the event to invite someone from the crowd to come join us and throw their hat in the ring, as it were. So a few people who are entering the event have decided to put their name in at the door for a chance to be chosen as a wild card artist. And we have just called that artist out of the crowd, and they're now making their palette, getting ready to join all of our pre-selected artists for round number two, starting in just a few minutes. Right now, we are looking at our featured art from our featured artists who painted as soon as the doors opened. And so these works were created over the span of an hour. We have Laura Freeman right now with this landscape here, and with the portrait is Anthony Campos. All of our artists are linked on the Art Battle Wichita Falls Instagram. So if you want to check out more of their work, make sure that you head over there and you can check out all of their accounts. We have just a few more minutes until round number two of Art Battle Wichita Falls begins. You can see that our artists are up at the easels, readying themselves, setting up their palettes, familiarizing themselves with their easels and their setup, and deciding which orientation they want their canvas to be. Really just getting their ideas set for round number two. You know, a lot of our battle is accomplished before the timer even starts. There's quite a lot of planning that can go into a 20-minute piece. So would love to hear in the comments from you guys, what kind of work do you want to see happening in this round? What would you paint in 20 minutes? And Art Battle Wichita Falls is also always looking for new artists to join us at the easel. So if you are interested in painting yourself and your mirror neurons are going off watching all of these artists compete, head on over to artbattle.com/artists. We would love to see what you got. Coming up in round number two, we have Sally Struck, Charles Smith, Catherine Stringfellow, Kerrigan Reyes, David Kay, and of course, our brave wild card artist. Really excited to see what that person makes. As I was just saying, a lot of the art battle works are created in the mind long before the timer starts. This wildcard artist was not pre-selected, and so they won't necessarily have a plan going in. So can't wait to see how that next level of improv affects their work. So always some exciting, surprising elements at art battle, to be sure. Round number two starting in just a few minutes. If you have not voted yet in round number one, make sure that you do at artbattle.com/vote. All of the works created tonight are available for silent auction. You can bid on them at that same link. So if there are any pieces that you've fallen in love with, make sure that you bid early, bid often, support these artists. Many of these artists are selling work for much higher prices out of their studio, so it's a great opportunity to collect accessibly. Here we are at the artist table, watching the artists making their paint selections, choosing their weapons for battle.
Resident, and he's also in the photography. Give him a round of applause.
has a degree in art, a PhD in computer science. She has cats, and she's a member of the Art Association. Give a round of applause.
Has begun officially for the second round of our battle in Wichita Falls. Here we are checking out the easel of Shaheem Jones, and Shaheem was actually chosen as our wildcard artist, so he was brave enough to put his name in the hat for a chance to be chosen to come up to the easels, and here he is. So Shaheem will have more to improvise, I think, than some of the other artists. And that can be a superpower in some ways. Maybe that might lend him the advantage of not getting too in his head, whereas other artists might have overplanned or get stuck in their plan. But lots of different challenges to overcome in only 20 minutes. Ooh, 19 minutes now. Here we are at easel number 5 with David White. And David is introducing quite a lot of green onto his palette. I'm feeling that this is going to end up being a landscape, not only because of the orientation of the canvas, it is in a traditional landscape orientation, but because we're getting a lot of color concentrated in the bottom third of the canvas and this green. So I think that a landscape is a pretty safe bet. But also with 18 and a half minutes left on the clock, it could go anywhere. Moving over to Kerrigan Reyes, and looks like Kerrigan is starting off her painting by painting the sides of the canvas black. So already we're getting a bold technique. Careful time management, I think, is the name of the game here with this color placement on the sides of the canvas. Usually we would consider that a finishing touch. So I think that Kerrigan definitely has something very specific in mind for this piece. So interested to see where she goes with that. We can see by Kerrigan's head piece that she's wearing that she's going to be bringing a lot of creativity and attitude to the easel. I really like it. I'm going to message her after and see if she can make me one or if she bought it somewhere. And now Kerrigan is going into the middle of the canvas, doing some drawing here. It looks like potentially with a marker and going in with some small lines in red. where is this piece going to end up? Would love to hear from you guys in the comments where you are thinking that that is heading. Back with David here. And a few red lines there that are just throwing me off from what I thought was going to be a pretty classical landscape. So interested to see how that piece evolves. Swinging on over here to Catherine Stringfellow, and really beautiful blends of color going on in the sky here in this landscape piece. I think that we might potentially be seeing a bridge or maybe a field, but the introduction of these kind of purple tones into the sky is really beautiful. We have that kind of classic sky blue up at the top, and then this purple that is surrounding it with all of this kind of fluffy cloud work here. And I think it's doing a great job adding depth to this piece. Working in kind of this almost a cobalt blue into the buildings. And I think that that, again, is going to be a great opportunity for depth and perception, as our eyes tend to perceive things that are farther away as having a blue tint. That was something that Da Vinci actually first employed in his paintings, was kind of creating a blue haze in objects that were further away. Charles Smith here, lots of blue and green kind of colliding into each other in the canvas here, meeting in the middle and blending together. And now we've got some shapes going on with this orange and yellow. Not sure where Charles is going with this yet. Is it going to be an abstract piece? Is it going to be figurative? Or are we going to see maybe an animal emerge? Would love to hear your guesses. And here we are checking out Sally Struck at easel number one, using what looks to be a palette knife, and using the shape of the palette knife, or perhaps it's actually just a really squared off brush. I think that's what it is. But she's very thoughtfully laying down this black paint over this grayish field. And there's a pretty heavy paint application here. And we can see that she's kind of using that brush to apply and kind of scrape away the underlayer at the same time. This piece is quite abstracted, but there's almost a geometrical kind of element to it, or a geometric element to it, just coming strictly from the shape of the brush that she's using. She's really embracing those sharp lines that are following from that. Headed back over to our wildcard artist, Shaheem Jones. Looks like we are getting a classic Superman S going on. I remember making those, and going in red, a pretty strong graphic element there. Will this piece become all text-based, or is he going to be incorporating different elements into this piece as well? It looks like he might be exploring different kind of graffiti typography. I think that we're seeing the second letter there taking on more of like a bubbly form, which is a pretty classic type form for graffiti. Back visiting with David White here. And I have a feeling we can see it just coming out, just peeking over from the side there. But I think that David's piece is going to give us quite the surprise when it's revealed. Shaheem here, continuing with the typography, struggling a little bit with that yellow bleed there. Yellow is such a difficult color to match up against wet, darker colors. You really take a lot of risk with the bleed there. So here's our surprise with David White. No longer a simple landscape that I had thought that it was. I think we now have a parrot in the foreground. So big surprise there. Great opacity in the colors that David is using there. That green, I think, would have been a challenge to overcome and to paint on top of, but looks like David has done a really good job getting a nice opaque coat of that red of this bird here. And really liking the way the shading of the beak is starting to turn very warm at the end, getting into that orange tone. Swinging back over to Kerrigan Reyes. And now we are getting an opportunity to see a little bit more what Kerrigan was working on. And looks like we have potentially some exotic dancers going on. That's maybe my impression here. We can see some figures. It looks like they're swinging around a pole there. But I think that there's an added element that maybe these figures have mushroom caps for heads. So really interesting here, very illustrative, very whimsical, and I think a little tongue-in-cheek as well. A lot of negative space in Kerrigan's piece, though. So that will be quite a lot of space for her to tackle in the next 9.5 minutes. We are now just over halfway through the round and would like to take an opportunity to remind everyone, if you're not yet registered to vote, please do so at artbattle.com/vote. You will enter your phone number. You'll receive a text message that gives you a special voting link for you to be able to choose your favorite artists. The top two artists from this round will be moving forward, joining the top two from the first round in a final showdown with another 20 minutes on the clock. So the best four artists, as voted by the audience, will paint again. Catherine Stringfellow here, just creating this beautiful, beautiful, peaceful landscape. I'm doing a really great job of contrasting these softer tones and cooler elements with the vibrancy of the grass here. This is a really skilled application of painting. We're really getting a sense of perspective here, and there's a definite balance in terms of the color interest and the palette. Whoa, so different from Charles Smith. I love this piece. I love the way that it's emerged. So we have, I think this is a cow portrait, and how could we ever have guessed that from just a few minutes ago when it was just this blue-green wash on the canvas? Really phenomenal job here. From Charles, and really interesting paint application technique. We're getting all of these kind of unexpected colors that are expressing brightness and shadow, but are not traditionally the colors that you would think of when you see a cow. So really thoughtful application technique here, and I think that that's bringing a lot of fun to this piece. A lot of whimsy here, a lot of fun, and really quite a lot of brightness coming through, even though a lot of the composition is leaning into the darker tones. With Sally Struck here, and a really wonderful piece, especially here in Canada for Remembrance Day. I'm not sure if it's the same in the States as well, but the poppy representing veterans, I think, in Sally's piece, and these beautiful just falling flowers. Really thoughtfully done, and well executed thus far as well. We can see that Sally is using a little bit of paper towel to kind of clean up the work. And to me, that's kind of communicating that Sally is quite close to being done. If the only details that she's thinking about now are making sure that her piece is clean and finished. So great time management there from Sally. With our wildcard artist, Shaheem. And we have, the word has emerged, and it is shy. So he is leaving his mark on Art Battle. Got that drip of color coming off of the Y. And I think that Shaheem did a good job of blending out the bleed that he had there when he originally created that yellow Y by adding the black outline around it. I think that was a really good save. Just under 5 minutes remaining on the clock. Head on over to artbattle.com/vote and choose your favorite artist. Another good opportunity to remind you guys that all of these pieces created tonight are available for silent auction at that same link. So make sure that you bid early, bid often, and take home the memory of watching one of these pieces being created. It's such a unique experience buying an Art Battle piece because you've seen this piece being born. And you know what it looked like from start to finish. So great opportunity to collect a piece of art, but also to collect the memory of it being made. Really unique work here from David White. We're seeing him adding in all of these stylized elements now, getting kind of these flourishes of feathered elements. And again, with that little pop of orange going into the bottom of the beak of the bird here, just kind of following that curve. Really thoughtful placement here, very careful work from David. Back over with Kerrigan Reyes here. And this piece is so much fun. There's so many different elements at play here. We have our mushroom dancers here. And then I think that Kerrigan is putting in some elements of a crowd below and at a bra kind of swinging off in the air. So very interesting here. Lots going on. And Kerrigan is definitely beginning to fill up that negative space that was a little worrisome earlier. A good gesture in the body of this figure. We can tell that one of the legs is swung around the pole and that there's movement there. We have now just only 2 minutes remaining in round number three. Round number two, our second qualifying round for Wichita Falls. Which artists will be moving forward into the third and final round? You guys will help us decide by voting at artbattle.com/vote. I think that there's a really strong contender here in Catherine Stringfellow's piece. This piece is just so strong. It really creates a sense of place. You can imagine yourself in this environment. There's a great expression of perspective here. We have some textural elements happening in the garden that's in the forefront and more softness in the background. Warmer, more vibrant colors up top in the bottom as they're closer to us, and those more cooler colors into the back. Really, really great job from Catherine here. Very, very strong piece. And we can see that she's working off of a reference as well. I would love to know whether or not, I think just based on the colors, that's a mini painting that she's made, and she's painting a painting based on one of her own works, and I love seeing that. 30 seconds remaining. Some really expressive work from Charles here. He's managed to create a piece that has a lot of brightness and vibrancy, while at the same time the majority of the tones would read a little bit darker. He's just done such a careful placement here.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, press it.
Our second round has now officially ended. Voting is open at that link on your screen, artbattle.com/vote. Please be sure to cast your vote. We often hear, often from our voting manager, Gina, that the winning artist can come down to just a single vote. And so it's really important that you choose who you want to support, because every single vote counts. As the votes roll in, we will be counting them, and we'll return shortly with our finalist announcements. have you.
I showed her your pictures last time I saw you.
Number three coming up in just a few minutes. We have in the final round Derek Holt III and Belinda Strayborn from round number one, and our finalists from round number two, Charles Smith and Catherine Stringfellow. Four very talented artists that I absolutely cannot wait to see work again. They will be taking the easel in just a few minutes. With another 20 minutes on the clock, we can see them resetting their palettes at this moment, deciding what they're going to be doing for their second painting of the night. Something we like to say at Art Battle is, all you need to do to win Art Battle is create the best painting of your life in 20 minutes, and then do it all over again and create an even better one. Who do you think is going to take the win tonight? We'd love to hear in the comments from our viewers. And who did you vote for? Did your favorites move forward? Round number three starting in just a few minutes. round number 3 of Art Battle Wichita Falls starting in just a few moments. Our final 4 artists are just getting ready to set their palettes and take them up to the easels to take on their final round canvas. Competing in this final round will be Derek Holt III, Belinda Strayborn, Charles Smith, and Catherine Stringfellow. Round number 3 beginning in just a few moments. If you are joining us just on the stream right now, make sure that you check out all of the paintings that were created tonight. You can see them at artbattle.com/vote. They are also available for silent auction. So if you are interested in any of those works, you don't need to be in the room at the event to purchase. We will ship them to you.
I want to thank everybody for coming tonight. I just want to tell you this, that today, over in Europe, represented Art Battle is being live streamed from London at their national event. Tonight, representing the United States, Wichita Falls, is the only one being live streamed tonight. So, the public going around here is filming this. They're seeing it all over the world. You can look on Facebook. You can look on YouTube. And you can see battles from everywhere. Now, this last round,
you get.
It will be painting for 30 minutes. Artists, remember that. Because if they forget it, they'll paint 20 and it'll be over. They'll stand there like their fingernails. I want to thank everybody for coming. We want to thank the Wichita Falls Art Association for sponsoring this. You get a chance at the Gallery of Faith in Ohio. Also, a neat thing that we are doing at the Art Association next week, we're trying to start an annual thing. There will be a wearable fashion show, wearable art. It's at the Museum of Midwestern. $20. We'll get you hors d'oeuvres and 2 glasses of wine. Woo-hoo! And you can watch a little fun style show. We have a lady over here, and Rihanna, instead of beans, she made both of these, and she's going to have stuff in there. Come on, Rihanna. They're new to Wichita Falls. All right, I'm going to kind of be quiet now. I appreciate everybody for coming and supporting the arts and support these artists. If you see them out on the street, thank them for taking the doors and getting up here and thank you. Y'all have a great night, and God save you when you go home.
That was our Battle Wichita Falls host, Bob Barrow, coming in with an announcement about support in the Wichita Falls community for the arts. Much appreciated. And Bob and Debbie, we would not have this incredible community in Wichita Falls happening around Art Battle without you guys. So very much appreciation going out to our team over there. I know that they have many team members and volunteers as well. And of course, a huge congratulations and thank you to all 12 of our artists for stepping up to the easels today. It takes a lot of creativity and courage to go up there and take on a blank canvas in only 20 minutes. So thank you so much to those artists. And I absolutely cannot wait to see how our final round is going to unfold. Our artists are taking the stage now. Countdown is imminent.
is 30 minutes instead of 20 minutes. So pace yourself, listen for time calls, don't panic. Alright, at the end of this, everyone will vote and we will pick our winner for tonight. Are you ready?
Countdown has begun for the third and final round of Art Battle in Wichita Falls. These finalists have, I've just been told, a 30-minute final round, so they have an extra 10 minutes on the clock to create these works. And especially for artists who are used to working in Art Battle, those 10 extra minutes can really be such a stunning gift. And just lend itself to creating even more incredible work, or can be a challenge if you're used to painting in 20 minutes and you have your strategy set out, say maybe in 5-minute increments, it can be difficult to know what to do with those extra 10 minutes. So some advantages and possible challenges coming with the increase of time for round number 3. In our final round, we have from the first round, Derek Holt III, who we can see working on his canvas right now with lots of small dots of color, and is kind of scraping that away with a palette knife. Very interesting technique here. Not one that I think that we've seen from him before. We're really used to seeing a lot of kind of gentle gradients from Derek, so this is a different style of painting, and we can see he's getting really performative with it there, getting very physical, which I'm sure the audience is just loving. And here we are with Catherine Stringfellow, I believe. And we can see that she is starting very subtly, again, with that same blue that we saw her first start with in her qualifying round. So interesting to see whether or not this piece is going to have a similar palette. Is it going to be a companion piece? Is it going to be very similar to the first round piece? Or is it going to be totally different? You know, we're seeing a larger canvas in addition to the extra 10 minutes. So lots of kind of wild elements thrown into the final round here at Art Battle. Charles Smith has created lots of kind of a wild color or watercolor wash cascading down the canvas, and just a huge amount of coverage in only 2.5 minutes. So very bold strategy from Charles. Coming around the easel here to Belinda Strayhorn. And it looks like Belinda is taking on a portrait for this round, and I think it's going to potentially be the only portrait in our final, which can be quite the advantage. People love to connect with a face, so I think that doing a portrait for Belinda's second painting of the night in the final round is going to be quite a strong strategy for her. A lot of great contrast going on here. Wondering if this is going to be some sort of recognizable historical figure, or if this is going to be more of an unknown person. rounding the easel, coming over to see Derek Holt here. And we can see that he's created this color field of super dark blue, almost a ultramarine color that he's just buffing into the canvas now. And we can see that he's working really hard for that dry brush and just really, it's called scumbling, actually, when you use a dry brush and kind of rub it circularly into the canvas there. And it's creating this almost like a burnished effect with this color here. And Derek is adding that color to the bottom. I'm wondering whether or not this is going to be just a totally the same color. Oh, no, I was wrong. The color that Derek just added onto the canvas is a pure black. And even though that blue is so dark already, we really get a sense of contrast and depth from that black. I think that Derek is switching it up and potentially going to be giving us a night scene. Some very careful brushwork here from Catherine Stringfellow. Getting kind of this sandy color surrounding this blue piece. Very interesting structure to this painting so far. Really leaving me guessing as to how it's going to be turning out. The colors make me want to think beach scene, but the way that brown color is cresting over and is jetted right up against that sky color really has me guessing. Would love to hear in the comments your guys' thoughts. I am feeling like it's sand with the directionality that she's using, kind of creating those lines. It makes me think of like curved beach. Definitely getting a sense of kind of a beach atmosphere, but not sure how that's going to be knit together with the sharpness of that line in the sky. So can't wait to see that. Swinging back to Charles here, and looks like Charles is taking on... Oh, I thought it was a floral, but now I'm thinking that it's a moth. Potentially a moth that has landed on a flower. There's a really gorgeous, kind of translucent quality to the wings of this moth here. Moth or butterfly. But we can see that Charles has just kind of buffed a little bit of white paint over that green wash that he had, and it's creating this kind of like semi-transparent quality, which makes you think of moth's wings and what their actual texture is in real life, and almost giving it like a semi-translucent. We are almost at the 20-minute mark, which means that the extra 10 minutes that were allotted for this final round have elapsed. Our first minutes, or sorry, the extra 10 minutes that have been kind of gifted to these artists. Now they're back into the regular art battle timing. So Belinda is still working on this portrait in a very central way. I think that these are larger canvases in the final round as well, which does kind of present its own compositional challenge. I would love to see this piece expand into some of the negative space that Belinda has going on around it right now. But with 2/3 of the round remaining, still lots of opportunity for Belinda to do that. Great use of contrast here. And we can see that Belinda is using a pretty small brush and is getting into the details of the face here. Interesting strategy to go into that kind of detailed space before tackling the rest of the canvas. Usually we're seeing artists kind of lay out their grand plan of how the space is going to be used and then going into the details, whereas Belinda is concentrating on the smaller aspects of this piece, and then I think is going to be adding kind of this performative element and surprising us with how she fills out the rest of the canvas. So interesting performance technique here from Belinda, and I'm here for it. We are heading over to Derek Holt, and looks like Derek has introduced some elements of light into this nightscape. Potentially could be something like an aurora borealis, maybe it's a galaxy, or maybe a smattering of stars across the night sky. Again with this beautiful softness. So really, really cool opportunity to see Derek paint this way. We've seen him paint in Art Battle Wichita Falls quite a few times, and each time he creates these really soft, softly blended environments. And I don't think that we've seen a piece that's this dark from him before. And so he's kind of blending that softness and style that he's known for with a totally different palette. And I have to say it's really refreshing and a totally different modality of performance because we saw him working quite aggressively in the beginning, laying on that color with the palette knife and really having fun with the physicality of his performance. So I think that Derek has come with a lot of serious strategy in mind. To Catherine Stringfellow. I am loving this piece. I'm loving this piece in all of the ways that it's confusing me. It's just making it so much more interesting. This the way that Catherine has framed this out is really adding a lot of almost a surrealist element by kind of creating this environment within this other shape. And almost 17 minutes left on the clock. Again, I can't wait to see how this emerges. I'm so drawn into this piece. I think that that is such a great audience strategy as well. I think that the audience is bound to be really engaged with this piece because it's keeping them guessing, just like it's keeping me guessing. Almost like looking out the mouth of a cave. Back with Charles Smith here, and we can now see that this is a butterfly, not a moth. And I think with based on the orange, it's gotta be a beautiful monarch. And a monarch that has landed on a gorgeous, vibrant sunflower. we can see from Charles' reference that he's holding as well. And I think that that reference is a printed photograph. So one of my favorite things about seeing artists paint from photographs is you can really see how the piece becomes translated through the lens of their artwork, their style. And from the way that Charles is executing this piece, we can see that there are painterly elements, we can see that there are illustrative elements, there's introduction of texture with the petals of the flower, and then of course this very painterly style with the wash in the background of that dripping green, just creating this lush environment for the butterfly to exist in. So lots of progress here from Belinda. She's really expanded this portrait into a larger composition. And it's the way that she's done that, I think, has really helped to ground the piece a lot. And she's done that basically just with the execution of the hair. So really, really beautiful work there from her. We have 14 minutes remaining. So now is a good opportunity to remind everyone, if you have not yet registered to vote, make sure that you go do that at artbattle.com/vote. You can see the link on the screen. You're gonna go there, input your phone number, and you will receive a text message with a special link to vote. You can also bid on all of the works created tonight at that same link. Many of these artists are selling their works for much higher prices out of the studios, so it's a great opportunity to really get in there and collect some incredible work from these artists, and with the added benefit of having seen it created live and having that memory associated with it as well. Really beautiful subtlety and use of contrast here from Derek. We have kind of these beautiful shooting stars, such stunning elements, just little surprises from Derek. I love that he really knows how to create a very broad environment that feels very expansive, and then adds in these small elements to kind of create scale and to draw us into the story and the environment of the piece. Just the impression of those two just super subtle strokes of white paint, creating that contrast and showing that they're shooting stars. Just such a thoughtful placement there. Swinging over to Catherine Stringfellow. And I'm so happy with how this piece has turned out. It's so, so engaging. We can see that this beach scene here, we're actually, us the viewer, are in a cave looking out at this beach scene and these rocks emerging from the water. This is such an incredibly unique piece. I am so happy that we got the opportunity to see it tonight, and really thoughtfully executed and well built by Catherine here. Really, when I say built, what I mean is there's so many different components to this piece that require a careful laying of paint. You know, she couldn't have thrown all of that black down right in the beginning and then battled that black, because she's got all of these lighter elements there and it would have bled and muddied things up. So Catherine's strategy of which layers she chose to add at what time, I think, is just shows a really high level of skill on her part. We have 10 minutes now remaining on the clock. Our final 10 minutes. Lots of vibrancy has been introduced by Charles here. Really enjoying the element of the addition of that red into the center of the sunflower just really sets it off and helps to harmonize it with the butterfly. And here we are getting just that little pop of contrast that I was so hoping for from Charles. The very, very needed addition of this darker green behind the petals of the flower to really help delineate them and separate them from the background. And he's just kind of buffing that out. Using the darker values closest to the petals and then kind of just scrubbing it into the background to create a little bit of a gradient. And that level of contrast just helps us focus on the center of the painting as well. Back with Belinda here. And this piece, the way that Belinda has approached it, it's taking on a very sculptural kind of ability. Lots of smooth planes in the face and opportunities for highlights. I would still love to see a little bit of grounding color just in the bottom third of the canvas. I am enjoying the fact that it's a monochrome piece, though. I do have a soft spot for monochrome work. Very contemplative expression on this figure as well. Over to Derek Holt, and we have yet another addition into this painting, these gorgeous silhouettes of trees emerging from the bottom of the canvas, really grounding this piece, bringing a lot of weight into the bottom and helping us to create that focus in the glowing sky. Really just creating this total environment. I think that this piece is definitely a contender for tonight. Just a reminder to everyone, you will help us choose the winner. The audience will vote for the winning artist, and there will only be one tonight. One winner out of these four finalists will be announced at the end of the event. And it is your job to vote for which artist you think is best. That artist will then move forward into the Wichita City or Wichita Falls City Finals. So the stakes are pretty high here tonight. Derek Holt was a competitor last season in the Texas Championship, and I can see that he is vying for his place again. We have just over 5 minutes remaining on the clock. And I am just absolutely stunned at Catherine's ability here to execute just this really, truly stunning work. Very thoughtful attention to detail, to the expression of light. We can see that she even has the reflection of the rocks in the water. And also playing with scale by using this window of the cave for us, and then perspective and showing that these rocks are very large in the water. Just really such an interesting composition. One of my favorite pieces, I think, that I've seen in art battle in quite some time. Can see that Catherine is just placing in her final refinements. Really, this piece is done, and she's just honing in on those last final details. Now bringing some of that yellow into the leaves of the plant. I really liked that mark that we just got of that swipe of yellow down the stem of the flower. Really gives us this 3D effect here. And since we were last over here with Charles, we also see these dots of white on the wings of the monarch, and just giving us that kind of signature look and creating a very recognizable, memorable image. Three minutes remaining. Coming over to Belinda, and she's added that darkness in the bottom quadrant that I wanted so badly. And it also helps to show us the kind of turning of the body that this portrait has. I think that just that addition there has created a lot of sense of communication of how this figure is moving and how this figure is posed. So great addition from Belinda there. Four very differently styled works in our final round here. I think that it's going to be a tough choice for our crowd. I think Belinda is going to be capturing a lot of eyes with this portrait here, a lot of recognizability there. People are often very drawn towards portraits. Derek's execution level here with this landscape is just beautiful, and I think it really shows off the breadth of his skill. From Catherine, we have that stunning and complex layered landscape of the beach. So I think that from a technical perspective, that's going to capture a lot of votes. And then we have Charles Smith with the vibrancy and super recognizable imagery. And the romanticism of a butterfly on a sunflower and the kind of hopefulness that that gives. I think that he's going to capture quite a lot of emotive power in his voting crowd. Our final countdown starting in just a few seconds.
I like that snow on the tree, bro. Appreciate it. I like the levels.
Right, the final round of our battle, Wichita Falls, has concluded with four incredibly strong pieces. Now comes the hard part for the audience to choose who you want to move forward and represent in the Wichita Falls City Final later on in the season. Do you want it to be Catherine Stringfellow with this incredibly complex landscape? Do you want it to be I think that we're moving over to check out our next artist. Do you want it to be Charles Smith with this vibrancy and whimsy and hopefulness coming through from this painting? You decide. I would love to hear in the comments who you guys are rooting for. As the votes roll in, we will be counting them, and every vote counts. We often hear from our voting manager, Gina, that a single vote can make the difference, all the difference in the world to one of these artists. So if you're having trouble choosing which artist you want to vote for, just go with your gut and choose one. Don't decide not to vote because you're indecisive. It really makes a difference. Every vote counts. We will be back in just a few minutes with our winner announcement. The votes are rolling in, and our announcement is coming in just a few minutes. Still time to get your vote in, so make sure that you do that at artbattle.com/vote. The auction will also be closing in just a few minutes, so if you have any of your bids in, make sure that you are not getting outbid on any of these works that you want to take home with you. A real display of so many different styles here tonight in Wichita Falls. Feeling very lucky to have witnessed all of the creativity and courage at the easels.
Okay, we'll go back to the artist who made it. So, again, the Portrait Wall of the Wichita Falls Art Association. So, you are donating to your gift card and the artist who donated it. So definitely do that, definitely vote. If there's only one t-shirt left, we can make the night and get all these t-shirts sold. She's on a mission. Also, ties. $4. So we can use tomorrow's coffee. So if you're like, man, should have got a tie. Just listen to me, just go do it. $4 is delicious. You will have no regrets. We're going to be announcing the winner shortly.
Once again, I'd like to say a huge thank you to all 12 of our artists that participated tonight. Actually, all 14, because we had two absolutely stunning featured artists who were not a part of the competition, but were painting as the opening act prior to the competition action. So big thank you to Laura Freeman and Anthony Campos. And to all 12 of our competing artists. It takes a lot of creativity and courage to step up to the easels, and we are so grateful to all of the artists in the Art Battle community. If you are interested in joining that community as an artist, we have events all over the world, and we would love to see your work. So go to artbattle.com/artists and show us what you got. Another thank you to our incredible team in Wichita Falls. They throw an absolutely stellar show. Really, really just wonderfully organized. So big shout out to Bob Barrow and Debbie Barrow and all of their large team of Art Battle team members and volunteers. There's a lot of moving parts in Art Battle, and they do it really, really well. And a big thank you to everyone who's watching with us on the stream and for your patience as we wait for our final winner announcement, which will be coming in just a minute or two. Winner announcement coming in just a minute or two. I believe that we are still collecting our final votes, so if you've yet to get it in, make sure that you do so.
This is a kind of big shindig, and
We hope you come back and make it a little bit bigger. I already thank the Art Association. I have to thank all these people running around here who work by the t-shirts on. They work their tails off, and all they get is a slice of pizza, a fried pie, a bottle of water, and a t-shirt. So, this wouldn't have happened without them. So we're going to give them a great big applause.
Just been announced for this edition of Art Battle in Wichita Falls. We're seeing him on stage right now. Derek Holt III, two incredibly strong paintings, really beautiful, well-executed landscapes from Derek Holt. And we absolutely cannot wait to see him moving forward into the Wichita Falls City Finals later this season. A huge thank you to all of the artists who participated tonight, to our incredible team in Wichita Falls, and to you, our lovely audience. Thank you so much to everyone who voted and bid on all of these works to support these artists. You can follow Art Battle Wichita Falls on Instagram at Art Battle Wichita Falls, and we will be streaming shows from all over the world at Art Battle International on Facebook and Art Battle on YouTube. So stay tuned, paying attention to those links, and we will be back soon streaming more shows. And everyone, have a great night. My name is Morgan Booth, and I have enjoyed being your host tonight.